Assalamualaikum everyone. So today in P5 we have covered topic 6.4, that is sunrise and sunset. Now as we all know that horizon is a line that separates the sky from the earth. And when the sun is above the horizon, it is sunrise. When the sun is below the horizon, it is sunset. Now, this sunrise or sunset or day and night are caused by the rotation of the earth. Like for example, this is a sun and this is the earth. Now, this imaginary line, which is an axis, it passes through the center of the earth. This axis is not in a straight position, it is slightly tilted towards the sun. Now, the upper half above the equator is the northern hemisphere, and the lower half below the equator is the southern hemisphere. The part which is quite tilted towards the sun must be having their summer right now because they are having the maximum sunlight. And the part which are the southern hemisphere, they are tilted away from the sun, so they must be having their winter right now because they do not have the maximum sunlight, they have the minimum sunlight right now. As the earth rotates on its axis, the part of the earth which is facing the sun is having the morning, and the part of the sun which is facing away from the sun, which is facing the back on the sun, is having their night. So this is how day and night are caused. Day and night are caused by the rotation of the earth. Now this is also how the seasons are formed. The seasons are formed by the tilt of the earth's axis. Like for example, just like I told you that the northern hemisphere right now is tilted towards the sun. It means that they are having their summer. This tilt never changes. Whether the earth goes here as it revolves on the orbit, whether it goes over here or here, this tilt remains same. But still, the northern hemisphere can be sometimes tilted towards the sun and sometimes tilted away from the sun. You can see this. Right now, the northern hemisphere are having their summer, the southern hemisphere are having their winter. But as it revolves, as it moves over here, the tilt of the north, the northern hemisphere are slightly away from the sun now. So it means that they must be having their autumn or spring. Now as it moves over here, you can see that the northern hemisphere has tilted away from the sun. It means now they are having their winter, and now the southern hemisphere are having their summer because they are tilted towards the sun. And as it comes over here, now they are having autumn. So it means when they are here and they are here, they have their moderate temperature, autumn or spring. But when they are here, tilted towards the sun or tilted away from the sun, they have their summer or winter. Now, it depends on the northern and southern hemisphere. Like we are in the northern hemisphere, Pakistan, China, Iran, some of the countries which are in the northern hemisphere must have their summer in like June, July. But it is opposite for the southern hemisphere. Right now, the southern hemisphere must be having their winters. So there is a chart given on 4.4, topic 4.4. The chart is of the length of the day of the Cape Town. The Cape Town is a city of South Africa, and that is actually in a southern hemisphere. So there is a chart, they show you the February and March, the length of the day of February and March. As you observe that chart, the length of the day of the February is becoming shorter day by day, and as it goes to the March, it has become even shorter. These days will keep on becoming shorter till 22nd June, which is their shortest day of the year. In southern hemisphere, 22nd June is the shortest day of the year because they are having their winters right now. But in northern hemisphere, 22nd June is the longest day of the year because we have our summer right now, and our length of the day is keep on increasing till 22nd June. Then after 22nd June, our length of the day will be decreasing. But in southern hemisphere, after 22nd June, their length of the day will keep on increasing till 21st December. which is our shortest day of the year, but in southern hemisphere it is the longest day of the year because they are having their summer. So what you have to do, you have to, in your homework, you have to do 6.4 question and answers. All the question and answers you have to solve in the copy, in the notebook, and you have to answer all these three questions. The question 1 and 2 are related to the chart that is given on 6.4 of the Cape Town, and question number 3 is actually to compare the length of the day of the Cape Town with the length of the day in your city. So I am sharing the chart of our city, the length of the day of our city in February and March 2020. So you have to see that what is happening. Are the days becoming shorter just like Cape Town, or are our days becoming longer? So I hope that you understand the homework, and I hope that you will be able to solve this nicely. Jazakallah.